Meet Europe in person.
Meet Europe in person.
Welcome to the Spinelli Group and European Federalists podcast series. Hello and welcome to the Spinelli Group podcast series. The aim of this podcast is to give you a view behind the curtains of European politics and give you the opportunity to meet Europe in person. In these on-the-point interview sessions, we will present to you insights into the background, the aims, and the activities of the Spinelli Group and its members. My name is Nana Walzer. It is a pleasure to host this series and to talk with some of the over 70 members of the European Parliament who are part of the Spinelli Group about what is happening, what is changing, and challenging the European Union. The Spinelli Group is a network of federalist-minded members of the European Parliament and Sandro Gozi, its current chairman. I'm happy to welcome Mr. Gozi for this, our introductory first Spinelli Group podcast episode. Thank you for your time.
Thank you.
To introduce you first to our listeners, you have a doctorate in public law from the University of Bologna, studied international politics in Brussels and international relations in Paris. You have published books, articles, editorials, have been professor at several European universities and have been a diplomat, as well as a member of the cabinet of the president of the European Commission and a member of the Italian Parliament, of the Parliamentary Assembly of the Council of Europe and Secretary of State for European Affairs in two Italian governments. Since 2020, you're a member of the European Parliament, where you serve, for example, on the Committee on Constitutional Affairs. In May 21, you were elected Secretary General of the European Democratic Party, and since 2018, you're President of the Union of European Federalists. Since 22, you're Chairman of the Spinelli Group. So let's take a look at the history of the Spinelli Group. The Spinelli Group is closely linked to the Union of European Federalists, a group that was established already on December 15, 1946 in Paris and is now a Europe-wide network with tens of thousands of members. What exactly is the relation between the Spinelli Group and the UEF?
Well, I mean, what do they have in common is a strong commitment to build up a federalist Europe, which means a Europe more democratic and more powerful, sovereign. Obviously, there are two different entities. The Union of European Federalists, which provides the secretariat of our activities as Spinelli Group, is the most ancient pro-European NGO. It is strongly rooted in civil societies around Europe, and it is strongly committed to promote a campaign initiative to strengthen European integration and to defend the cause of a federal Europe. The Spinelli Group is the best ally of the Union of European Federalists within the European Parliament. It goes back to one initiative of Attilio Spinelli. This is why, by the way, we are called Spinelli Group. Attilio Spinelli was a prominent member of the European Parliament, a great federalist. And when he was member of the European Parliament, he had founded a club, a network of like-minded members of the Parliament, which used to be called the Crocodile Club. They used to meet and plead the cause of a stronger and more political union. This network, this cooperation among like-minded members of the European Parliament is the origin of very important proposal, which is the treaty, the resolution on the Treaty for a European Union of 1984, on the experience of this Crocodile Club, a network, a federalist network was created in the form of an intergroup within the European Parliament. And then in 2010, on the initiative of Guy Verhofstadt, the Spinelli Group was created. What is this group? It is a group where members of the European Parliament from different political groups, from different political parties, from different countries. They are united and cooperate as I was saying, a more democratic, a more powerful Europe. And it is a very useful network to plead to defend our cause within the European Parliament, but it's time also to let the public, the general public, the citizens know better what we are and what we do, and what we do together with organized civil societies, in this case with the Union of European Federalists.
Wonderful. So let's get a little bit deeper into what the Spinelli Group is all about. So one of the major success factors of the Spinelli Group is the common idea of a federalist Europe. This idea brings together members of the European Parliament that even belong to very different political families. Do all those quite diverse members of the Spinelli Group have actually the same vision of a federal Europe, or do they differ when it comes to the details?
Well, I mean, I would say that we agree on the essential, as we agree on the essential with the also with the Union of European Federalists. What do we mean by a sovereign and democratic Europe? We mean a Europe that is really effective, that decides by majority, that is freed from the veto, which imprison Europe when the time comes to take difficult decision, for example, sanction against Russia during the war, or major action on foreign policy, or major action in the field of rule of law. Today, when the Union has to take this decision, very often in the European Council, in the institution where the head of state and governments regularly meet, a government can block the whole European Union, putting a veto. It's clear when we talk about a democratic and sovereign Europe, we want a Europe which decides by majority, because after all, Europe has reached its main achievement, decided by majority. If you had to decide by unanimity the single market, we would be still waiting for the first decision, for example, of free circulation of workers or goods. So, I mean, the fourth thing is fight against veto for a more efficient and more democratic Europe, because Europe cannot be efficient and cannot be democratic if one country blocks all the others. More democratic Europe means a Europe where the European Parliament is really put at the full service of the citizens and can enjoy of the powers and the prerogative necessary to fully serve the citizens. So we want any laws, any European laws, to be taken both by the Council, by the representative of the government deciding by majority, together with the representative of the citizens, that means the European Parliament. And we want also the European Parliament to be able to bring the attention of the other European institutions some strong citizens' demand, exercising directly the right of legislative initiative. Today, the European Parliament still does not have the right to present laws. It must wait for the proposal of the Commission. And also, we want to make build up Europe differently. We want to make Europe differently. We want to make Europe and we want a more democratic Europe, not only by strengthening the role of the representative of the citizens, but also by complementing the European Parliament with new form of direct democratic participation. We want the citizens to be in the front line, in the driving seat, when it comes to discussing which Europe we want, which solution we want, which concrete policies we want to tackle the common challenges. And this is what we did with the Conference of the Future of Union, which is an exercise about which we haven't spoken enough. The public opinion is not enough informed about the fact that for more than 1 year, 800 women and men, one third of these young, under 25 year old, have met basically every weekend to decide which European future they want. And then some representative of them, as we call some ambassadors, as more than 100, have discussed with an equivalent number, again, more than 100, 108 members of the European Parliament, representative of national parliament, representative of national government institutions. And we have agreed on 49 proposals to change Europe, to change European policies, to provide concrete answers on the new need for education, for school, for apprenticeship, for job creation, for climate change, for security, for foreign policy, for a more democratic Europe, to build up a truly European transnational political space by strengthening the role of European political parties, European civil societies. Basically, together, but with the citizens at the center, we have made proposal to reshape Europe. This is what means being federalist today. And I think that this can provide a very good part of the answer our citizens are waiting for, because it is clear that faced with transnational challenges, challenges which goes well beyond the capacity of the different member states, think of climate change, think of security, think of global finance, think of the need of new digital regulation, things of migration, where we have to take back control at the right level. All this issue needs a new answer at the European level. This answer must be effective and must be democratic. They cannot be left to the veto of the single government. They cannot be left to the expert. They cannot be left to the diplomats. They must be tackled and taken in both an efficient, democratic way. This is what unites all the members of the Spinelli Group. This is what unites the Spinelli Group members and the active citizens in the Union of European Federalists. And this is also what unites most of the citizens which have gathered for more than 1 year in the Conference of the Future of Union.
Beautiful. We talked now about the goals and actually the concrete aims of the group. When we jump now from the goals to the action that is being taken by this Spinelli group, the group aims, and I quote now, to find a federal majority among MEPs, members of the European Parliament, on important subjects, such as, for example, the federalization of the EU. That's, of course, the major topic, but also the commitment to strengthen the European integration, the EU institutions as well. So how exactly can we envision, can we see in front of our inner eye what the Spinelli group is doing in an everyday life? How do you come together? How do you find common directions? And how do you influence the political process of change?
Well, first of all, you rightly recalled, and as we have said since the very beginning of this conversation, we are women and men coming from different political groups, different political parties, and different countries. And we want to influence in a positive way the decision of the European Parliament, because we want more democracy in Europe. We got a stronger role for the citizens, and we want to provide more effective and concrete solutions at European level, wherever and whenever and a European action is necessary, because we fully respect the role of the local communities, the city, the region, organized civil societies, the member state. We want to intervene and we want a new European action only when it's really needed, at when the European level action is really needed to tackle and win the outstanding challenges that we are facing today. And for example, we have pushed the European Parliament to adopt a resolution, to adopt a strong political commitment to ensure a follow-up to the recommendations of the citizens which have gathered in the Conference of the Future of Union. There are the citizens have asked, for example, a union of energy. They ask for an effective common a European policy for energy. And we know, we see now with the Ukrainian crisis, how is important to have new and more effective common energy solutions as Europeans. They want a Europe which protects. They want a Europe which better defends our values, our interests, and our borders. So they ask for a sort of European army, on at least a European defense through a new form of networking and cooperation between the European armies of the different member states. They ask for a union where we can really put at the service of the where we can promote new European common goods. Think of new health policies at European level. think of effective green transition, manage ecological transition managed by the European level, a more effective protection of the European common borders. All these are initiative on which we have decided to take a responsibility. We have asked the other institution, the Council, where there are representatives of the government, the Commission, which is there, to implement the decision of both the Council and the Parliament to promote new initiative, be they new laws, be they new European programs, be they modification of the treaty, which are a little bit our common constitutional basis, because there are some issues which require treaty revision. We have worked as Spinelli Group within the different political groups with the same approach, with the same strategy, and we have brought the Parliament to adopt the resolution to ask that all this happen, and to ask at least the national government, the Commission, to take a clear stance on the request of the citizens. The citizens have asked to have more transparency, to have a more effective way of voting in the European Parliament elections, to be able to vote also through digital means, to have the possibility, if a member state decide to do so, to vote when you are 16 years old or 70 years old. They ask more gender balance in the list at the European election. They ask to be able to directly vote the European political parties, because today we have a strange situation where we have a European Parliament, we have European political parties, but we do not elect the member of the European Parliament voting the European political parties. We elect them voting national list through 27 national debate in the 27 member states, and the citizens, and we agree as Spinelli Group, says no. We want to elect at least part of the member of the European Parliament by voting directly the European political parties, because we want to build up this new democratic and political level dimension, which is missing today in European democracy, and which is the European level and the European political dimension. We have also adopted a resolution and request the other institution to modify the treaty, for example, to grant the European Parliament the right of legislative initiative, to let the European Union in all the cases with some exception to vote by majority. It has been done. On all this, we adopted formal position, we have presented proposal, and now we are fighting, politically fighting, especially with the Council, because we want to see most of this happen. We want to see all of this happen, but certainly we don't accept what is happening today, where the Council, the national government, are simply buying time. They are kicking the can down the road, and they do not show the necessary sense of urgency. In this historical phase, there is a strong urgency to implement important radical reform to better equip the European Union and let the European Union really being capable of providing the right answers to the European citizens. And this is what we are committed to do, and we are doing as Spinelli Group. We meet basically every month. We are in permanent contact through, mail, through other digital opportunities, but we regularly meet in person to share the possible common strategies.
You give us now a great overview of what the Spinelli Group is actually working on and what important changes there are to be tackled. If we take a little look into the past and aim for the successes that already have been reached, which are the main successes that would come to your mind that the Spinelli Group already fought for, but also that, for example, the Union of European Federalists fought for and really implemented on the European level?
Right. First of all, to make the Conference of the Future of Union happen, because at the beginning it was a proposal promoted by Emmanuel Macron in March 2019, but there was a lot of skepticism. And through the action within the European Parliament of the Spinelli Group, outside the European Parliament, also the Union of European Federalists, in close cooperation with some like-minded government and leaders, such as, for example, the French president, we managed to make it happen. We managed to build up a Europe differently. We managed to show that direct democratic participation is not there to challenge the representative democracy, is not there to challenge the parliaments, national or European, is there to strengthen the representative democracy, to build, develop another dimension of democratic participation. We have made a formal proposal, for example, to reform the European political parties. We want the European political parties to be more effective. We want to give the citizens the possibility to vote directly the European political parties, but we want also more transparency when it comes of conflict of interest, when it comes of financing. We think that you cannot propose to increase the political importance of the European political party without asking to these parties to become more transparent, more accountable. And on our side, we have adopted a reform of this, as we have adopted reform of the European electoral law, as we have proposed to reform the treaty to being able to provide the citizens the right answer. For example, the citizens want that when it comes, for example, of the big financial multinational groups, we can decide the taxation issue by majority, not by unanimity, because they think that this also, this taxation dimension of the big cross-border multinational actor is part of a new form of social justice, of fiscal, of tax justice. And I think that they are right. So we have concretely made either taken decision or concretely made our formal proposal to make it happen. Of course, the European Union is a system where everything must be shared between those who represent the interests of the states and those who represent the interests of the citizens. So all these proposals now are being discussed with the representative of the states, with the council, where the different ministers and the different prime ministers represent and defend their national interests. This is how Europe works. And this is why also Europe is very democratic, because you got both legitimacy. You got the legitimacy which derives from your member state, and which is the whole democracy, and all in a legitimate way express the will by electing their prime minister, but you got also the other form of legitimacy of the one which that we embody in the European Parliament as representative of the citizens. So, I mean, on many proposals, thanks to the Spinelli Group, the representative of the citizens have proposed new concrete solution in this Europe of solutions that we want to build. Now we have to negotiate with the representative of national interests and national state.
Europe of Solutions, that's a great summary of the aims of the Spinelli Group. We promised in this series to also give a little bit of insight into the European parliamentarian, him or herself. So Meet Europe in Person is our slogan. So in that concern, what is your personal main goal as a member of the European Parliament, as being part or even chairman of the Spinelli Group? What is your main goal and also your main message to all our listeners?
That my main goal and my message and my main commitment is to tear down the national barriers to a continental democracy and to truly continental politics and to truly continental political and democratic participation. I am Italian. I was born in Italy. I got experiences, as you mentioned, in several member states, but I was elected for the first time in the national, in the Italian parliament. I was a member of the Italian government. And then I went to the other country which I know best, which I've chosen. Italy is the country I love, where I was born. But France is another country which I love and which I chose. And there I was elected at the European Parliament. Why did I do so together with Emmanuel Macron? Because I think that we need also to embody this idea of democracy without borders. And what we need to build up in our European Union is not only a democracy, but a democracy without borders. So there is a dimension of there is a European dimension, there is a transnational dimension of our democratic community, which we still must build. It is not enough to elect a member of the European Parliament with 27 different electoral systems, 27 national debates. We need also to develop a European dimension, a common dimension of this. We need to embody the right which we all have since 1992, even since before. Each of us can freely live in another European country, can vote in any country where he lives or she lives, and can be elected at the municipal level, as mayor, as municipal councillor, or the European Parliament in any country where she or he lives. And this is a right that we have since at least 35 years, 40 years, but nobody knows. Europeans are not aware of all the rights, the additional rights that the European Union is granted to them to live as free citizens in a free continent. And my choice is to embody this aspect of European citizenship. And I'm very grateful to my colleagues of the Spinelli Group because they all share this approach and because they allow me now to represent as a rotating chair, this common fight. And it is a very important fight, not only for Europe, but for democracy and for freedom of each of us as citizens of a free continent.
Democracy without borders and the Europe of solutions. Thank you so much for this great introductory podcast episode, Mr. Gauthier, and every luck in the world for you and all your goals. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.